So first we have to discuss the basic terminologies in circuit analysis. So first one is circuit. First one is circuit. What is circuit? What is electrical circuit? Which is nothing but an interconnection of electrical elements in such a way that there is a closed path for the flow of current. There is a flow of current in this circuit. For that flow of current, there is a path. Then only it can be called as circuit. Okay? An interconnection of electrical elements such that there is a closed path for the flow of current. So, if there is a closed path in that, obviously that is circuit. So, if we consider one example, so this is the circuit. So, this is the voltage source. We have to discuss in detail about the sources and these elements. So, interconnection of electrical elements. What are the electrical elements? We have R, L and C. So, we have to discuss these three elements in detail in future. So, just for time being, you have to assume these elements in this circuit. Okay? Just for time being, you have to assume these are present in this circuit. But we have to discuss in detail about this elements as well as the sources. Okay? So, before starting that, first we have to discuss what is circuit, what is network. That is very important, right? So, interconnection of elements. Here I am choosing the only resistor value. Maybe the circuit may be. Combination of R and L and C. This could be the circuit. When it is called as circuit, there is a closed path for the flow of current. Then only it could be called as circuit. That is, so because of this voltage source, there is a current. So, maybe this is R 1, this is R 2, R 3, or you can call it as capital R 1, capital R 2, capital R 3. Okay. So, here is supply voltage and this is R, this is C, this is L. So, this is a closed path, right? So, it means the current is like this, this is I 1 for example. So, this is the second path for the current I 2. So, means the starting point and the ending point of the current in a loop is same, then only it could be called as what? Closed path. The starting point and ending point of that corresponding current should be same, then only it could be called as closed path. Then only there is a path for the flow of current. So, from this is the path for the current I2, the same. So, this is I1, this is I2, that is it. This is simple circuit. That is an interconnection of electrical elements such as R, L and C in such a way that there is a closed path for the flow of current. For the flow of current, then only it could be called as circuit. Next we have to discuss about network. First one is circuit, next one is network. What is network? An interconnection of elements which may or may not have closed path, which may have or may not have the closed path. It is called as network. Means, see, we have supply voltage and we have one element and we have another element. Maybe here I am assuming inductor, here it is capacitor. Okay. So, this is network. So, here a closed path for current I1, a closed path for current I2 and Here, these two terminals are open. There is no closed path for this loop C, which may or may not have closed path. So, this entire part is nothing but what? Network. This entire part is nothing but network. We can consider one more example. So, this is also a network. So, there is no closed path for this last loop. So, this loop cannot have a closed path. So, only this path and this path, I1, I2, and there is no path for I3. Okay? So, from these two conclusions, we have to conclude one thing, that is, this is what? Network. And this is circuit. Means what? This is very important observation. That is, circuit is the subset of network. Circuit is the subset of network. That is, all circuits are networks, but all networks are not circuits. This is very, very important note point. That is, all circuits are called as networks, but all networks cannot be assumed as circuits. This is very important observation. Means simply, circuit is the subset of network. That's it. So, next one is planar network. That is third one. Third one is planar network. So, what is planar network? That is, any network that can be drawn in a 2D plane. So, any network that can be drawn in a two-dimensional plane. For example, if we consider So, this is the simple network. So, we have to draw this network into 2D plane. So, this could clear. So, this circuit or this network could be drawn like this. So, this red color marker arrangement is this outer part, and this blue color marker arrangement is nothing but in this pattern we have to arrange. So, this point is nothing but this point. So, this is what? Drawn in 2D. So, whatever may be the network, that should be drawn in 2D, drawn in 2D plane, then only it could be called as planar network, otherwise non-planar network, otherwise non-planar network. So, this is the another example for planar network. So, now we have to check whether it could be drawn in 2D plane or not. Okay. So, first we have to write this blue color marker network. This is 2D plane for this network. See, this blue color marker is nothing but like this, and this red color marker can be incorporated in this network. That is, can it could be drawn like this, that is 2D plane. So if we are able to draw 2D plane, that is planar network, otherwise non-planar. So what is non-planar network? What is non-planar network? Any network that cannot be drawn in a 2D plane, then it could be called as non-planar network. So this is planar network, no? So what is non-planar network? Simply, so this is non-planar network. So from here to here, there is a branch. Simply, this is non-planar network. So we cannot draw in 2D plane. So this is non-planar network.